So chat two with my guest, Randula De Silva. We share the same surname. Nice. I'm enjoying my sea bass. And what are you having?
I'm having paneer with, I think, vegetable korma. Yes. Okay. Well, Indian.
We have to pause our food and talk, Randula.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, happy to.
Tell me, how did you get to today, this stage in your life, from being that respected head prefect at Muses College? Not that you're disrespected now, but that journey.
Yeah, sure. I cringe sometimes at the thought of my days of being the head prefect. Of course, I'm proud of all that I did, but I think extreme rule maker, mm-hmm. To rule breaker, mm-hmm. to now, I think it's been quite a journey. And it's just about saying yes to adventure, saying yes to things that, you know, fires your soul. And a lot of things changed for me when I got selected by accident. I really don't know how it happened, to Colombo University. So I was never the celebrated kid in school. Even head prefect was, you know, something that I was thrown at. But it really gave me wings to embrace the leader that I am. And Colombo University was a similar thing. And there, meeting all these different people from different communities, it really opened my eyes. So I think those were instrumental to what I am today.
Now, disrupting is not the only thing you do. You work in lots of other areas, such as liberal topics like love, sex, alcohol, you know, all that stuff. It's totally contrasting to Good Life X and to Hatchworks, or connected, but also, you know, yeah. How does all that part happen?
I think I put you on the spot by trying to define all of that in one sentence because it's so contrasting.
Yeah, you're going to be totally confused.
But I don't think it's too much different. Sure, Good Life X and Hatch is taking an entrepreneurial business take on it. But there also, it's really trying to be progressive and looking at things in a much more different, futuristic way. And if you take the other topics that I have been working on since, I think, 2009 even, on, you know, working together as one to let go of all these racial, religious extremism issues that we have in this country, to be not so open about love or sex or this whole issue of females not being able to purchase alcohol. All of these things, I think, resonate still at the same core, where you look at things with an open mind and not with a restricted mind. So open mindset, growth mindset in whatever I do is what I apply. And this I don't think is easy for a lot of people to fathom, including my mom. But that's what I am.
Due respect to who you are and what you're doing, isn't all this Colombo-centric? Could you go out into Dahiyatta Kandia? And tell these things to the women there.
Yeah, I mean, in fact, my work began from Jaffna, Kumar. My venturing into startups started from Jaffna because I randomly walked into a community.
What I meant was love, sex, alcohol.
Yeah,
that part of it.
So I work with a group that's advocating the topic of sex through a bunch of initiatives called Faculty of Sex, and there
it's
yes, and that's in Sinhala. It's not in English. We are only translating the books written in Faculty of Sex to English now. So it has reached the masses already. And when you speak to women around these topics, and people who purchase these books are mostly, you know, sari wearing, government working women.
The traditional.
And they hide it under other books in book fair, right, when they purchase it. I've seen these things. So it's not easy to be talking to these communities, Colombo or outside, but it's how you approach it and how you apply it and how relatable you are. So I think people outside Colombo are more liberated, I think, than people in Colombo.
You think so?
Yes.
You really do?
Yes. I mean, here, it's a very Victorian society in a way. But
there are
our
facades
roots.
And facades and
exactly.
Facades.
Exactly. You really fake who you are and the reality in life.
With all this work you do you have time for your husband? Do you have time for yourself? Do you have time to spend together, husband and wife time? You really have that?
I mean, I think our husband and wife time is not by the book husband and wife time. I don't think we even call ourselves husband and wife. We are in a partnership. but in a very
relationship.
Well, a very unconventional relationship, which is obviously bound by love. But we do a lot of interesting work together. So the Faculty of Sex project is my husband's, and we work on it together. And I edit all his books in Sinhalese. He's an author as well and a creative guy. And I executive produced his film Avilena Suli. So I think our time together is by creating more and more projects that really opens out new avenues to the Sri Lankan society to look beyond our island mentality and to really, you know, embrace the real you.
So would one be correct to say that your entire life has been a successful model, or have there been failures too?
I mean, in every chapter, in everything that you try to do, there is failure. There's no one way or one thing that you do that where you like you switch on a button and it just works out. Things go wrong. I mean, in our film, when we worked on it 5 years ago, everything went wrong. And last year, when it hit the screens, COVID hit us, everything went wrong. But it's about how you learn from it or how you use that uncertainty as an opportunity to turn it towards what you want to achieve.
The film, for example, so COVID struck, you know, cinemas closed down. How did you turn that into a plus?
Well, I think we talked about it in different platforms. We got people to know about it and used unconventional ways of letting people know about it. And even during the time of a pandemic, our film was the most attractive film for people to come into and watch. I'm not saying it was great in terms of numbers as a normal Sinhalese film would have been.
In the circumstances.
Exactly, yes. It did well.
Have you always wanted to be the entrepreneur you are today?
I don't call myself an entrepreneur. I don't think that's what I am. I think I am a catalyst, if I, for the lack of a better word. I just bring amazing people together and make things happen. I work towards change. I work towards making things better than what they are. Entrepreneur is, I think, one vehicle that allows you to do it. Art is another form. So that's why I'm, you know, crosswalking across all these fields.
So you being the catalyst you are, what are your thoughts on Sri Lanka's community of female entrepreneurs?
I think there's a lot of trailblazing women in Sri Lanka from back then to now. If you look at my mum to grandmum, they don't label themselves as entrepreneurs. My mum was a banker who's worked in a bank for 30 years. But the way they look at problems, the way they solve problems, the way they make us sustain, I think that's very inherently special in Sri Lankan women. So I think Sri Lankan women are a resilient breed who's relentlessly striving towards nurturing and making things better. I've seen a lot of amazing women with very many visions and very assertively doing it. But I think common to every woman in the world, we undersell ourselves so much. But I think future is looking great.
Pradula, time management would be critical in your life to be productive. Now, juggling all these things, how do you quantify your time? How do you compartmentalize your time?
Yeah, I think I was pushed to the deep end when I embraced a dual role 2 years ago. And I was pushed to really achieve a solution for myself. I read a few books, talked to a few people, and I think I've distilled a solution for myself, which works out very well. I wake up early and I have a schedule set. So in my personal life, I'm a very fluid and a free-flowing person, you know, take it as it comes, whatever. But in my professional life, I really regulate my time and how I give my time to others in a very tightly curated way in order to make everything work. So until 11 a.m., I don't meet people or take meetings at all. It is time for creative work. It is time for deep focus. And 11 a.m. onwards, I have a block for meetings. I wake up at 6. Yeah, 5 is something I want to achieve, but I wake up at 6. Also because it's tough with my husband, you know, and Netflixing away into the night, watching so much of interesting stuff, which I don't want to say no to.
Don't we binge watch?
Exactly. So you have to compromise on whichever. I then go into the bunch of meetings that I would go into and checking my emails. All of that starts after 11 so that my mind doesn't get muddled up with all the noise from the world before on. So then I have the chunk of the work that I want to do for the day done already in the morning, which leaves me time to meet my team. And I have recurring meetings for each team member every week so that I make sure that I have time blocked for these people as well. Because whatever you do in life, whichever company you are working in or whichever project you're working in, it's the people that makes it work. You have to spend time with them and connect with them and know about their lives in and out. It's not about work productivity or KPIs. It's about how do I help you achieve your best self? How can I enable you to do that? So I think it's really how you compartmentalize your day and work with the people around you.
Being the catalyst you are, moving around in a curated manner, in a fluid manner, what's your next adventure?
I think I get excited by a lot of interesting and new things, but looking at where I am right now, GLX is taking on a new life and wings of its own. And I've been very, very curious, and this is what I'm going to deep dive into in the sectors of nutrition and wellness and innovations in these spheres. And I've had a very personal experience 6 years ago when I lost my mother-in-law to cancer. And it's, you know, it's something that pops up in every nook and corner in our modern lives. It's part and parcel of our lifestyles. So by changing the way you eat, changing the way you look at food and grow food, a lot of these also can be addressed. So I'm very curious to deep dive into this topic.
Where do you see yourself in 10 years from now? I'm talking of February 2031.
Yeah, cooking up a storm somewhere. I think how I how I really like to live and have always lived is being in the middle of some form of change, creating it and you know, shaking things up. So I don't think I will ever stop being that, whether I'm an entrepreneur, a mom, a business leader, an artist, whatever it is, I'll be in the middle of a storm, cooking it up and making change happen.
So not a storm in a teacup, but certainly a storm in the corporate world, changing people's life and motivating, basically, being a catalyst and motivating. Radhula, thank you so much. It was interesting, very interesting talking to you. I learned a lot myself. So good luck with your journey. 10, 20, 30, 40 years, long, long way to go. Thank you so much. Good luck.
Thank you for having me, Kumar. I really had fun.
Same here. So we get down to her Thai lunch and my sea bass at the Grace Kitchen, Hilton Colombo. We meet you again next week with another edition of Aperitif with Kumar. In the meantime, cheers. Bon appétit.
Bon appétit.